Alas, poor Gaiety. I knew it well. Hey everyone, Spaz here, and yes, as of today, Universal Studios Hollywood has officially retired the Gate A front of the line program in place of something else. And to be perfectly honest, I'm not all that surprised by the change. In fact, its days were numbered when Forbidden Journey lost 3D, but I'll get to the correlation of that in a second. First, let's discuss what's replacing it. I give you Universal Express! What is that? It's essentially the same thing. More or less. If you've been in Florida or the other Universal parks, it's that thing. And full disclosure, as an employee, I found out about this a little earlier than the public, and I immediately started going through a few scenarios in my head that could have easily backfired on them, but trust me, it's all taken care of. It's literally just a name change. That's it. So if you have a Platinum Pass, that gets you Express. If you purchased a front of the line ticket for a day after the 5th, that will be an Express Pass. And if you've been hoarding these, yeah, these are really the only casualty of the Express name change. In fact, these used to be our go-to to recover guests if there was a delay of any kind or if the ride just straight up broke down. And as I've never been to the Florida parks, I don't know how their recovery works. So if you've ever gotten stuck on a ride or if it broke down on you, please let me know in the comments how it works, but the bigger question is, why the change? Well, I have been mentioning Florida a lot in this video, haven't I? Yeah, after we lost Larry Kurzweil and got a shiny new Karen Irwin, who is from Florida, that's when things kind of started changing around here. Forbidden Journey doesn't have 3D there, so why do we need it here? The name tags are too erratically different from venue to venue, so let's just unify them. Gate A? Why not Express? Now, if you look at all of this from the perspective of the business, it makes sense. Unifying everything under one brand, under one specific program, makes sense. It's easier for us, it's easier for the guests, everybody's happy. Mostly. But I can't help but feel we lost a little bit of our identity. I mean, outside of the fact that we have the Starway, the studio tour, and we are still a real working movie studio that was here first, and without this place, there wouldn't be any. I mean, look at the difference between Disney World and Disneyland. They have two completely different ways to acquire a Fast Pass, because Disney World knows it's a tourist destination. That's not to say that Disneyland isn't, but let's face it, it's mostly populated by locals. Same thing with Universal Orlando. It's the tourist destination. It has more things to do. Us? We tiny. We're not even a full day park. There shouldn't even have been a front of the line system to begin with. But I digress, that's a much deeper topic that I will definitely get into in the retrospective next year. In the meantime, if you come to the parks and notice that we have Universal Express now, again, don't be worried, just a name change. Still gets you into a faster line. So, all good stuff. Just wanted to make this video just kind of a little PSA, a little editorial on the fact is, obviously I have a lot of strong opinions about this. So yeah, make sure you subscribe, help us out with Patreon. I got a cool new picture up there that you might want to look at. It involves Mr. Ragey, Mr. Savio. It's pretty fun, so. I'm rambling. Do all that good stuff. I'll have other videos up here. And until next time, I'm Spazmaster. Later.